I will speak about Mars operation and space. It is actually based on Odia syntactic structure. All of you know the most important fact about Mars, that is, Mars is a process of building multi-dominant syntactic structure. And the most important point is that Mars actually does not create abelian group in the language which is based on fixed word order. In the language which has fixed word order, like Odia and other languages, Hindi are like this, here actually it creates cyclic principle. That is, object verb creates VP with an object, then subject, like this. But I do not know what is the the language where pre word order occurs. There it may be abelian group. Second thing, people know that merge is itself a kind of operation, but that is not so. Merge occurs over a particular operation. That operation it creates syntactic structure specific in a space. Space is concerned with a semantic space, a particular idea, a particular meaning. So that derivation of syntactic structure occurs in space. Actually, this study, so many linguistics, very prominent linguists, from Chomsky and Bogoljic and Swett and Collins and Stabler, they have already spoken about it. Okay, but I have taken this data actually from Odia language. Odia is an Indo-Aryan languages, and it is a SOB order language, prodrop and a morphological reach. This is the nature feature of this language, and I have taken data, the sentences from native speaker, from our telephone conversation, and some from newspaper or literature like this. The significant most prominent linguists, they have already told about this syntactic structure, merge as a process of combining syntactic structure. But what thing or what fact motivates me to study this, to take this research, that are these following facts. For example, you can say, how does merge deliver syntactic and semantic expansions about sentence? What grammatical rule of language emerges? It means grammatical constraint emerges from process of merge. And the third point is, how does operation of a merge create space? Whether there is a single space for derivation of all sentences, or each derivation has a single space. These are the important facts which motivate me to take this research. And I will specifically answer these questions in this study. And this is the very common structure. All of you know, actually, Hansen and Chomsky and all these people have drawn this structure. Actually, this is the syntactic structure that Mars can create. But if you see these structures, you can see there is a simple structure, and from simple structure, a type of metric structure is generated, and within a matrix structure there is another independent structure in all these three types of structures. And it can be left side, it can be right side also, but it is a language specific. But in Odia, it is always from right, not left. And here data you can see, suppose for example, Madhu Sidhu Ishuku Bhalapaya Boli Kahila. Here you can see, this is the matrix sentence and there is a embedded sentence after the noun phrase. And second sentence you can see champa phuspus kala je santani aslan champa whispered madam came. So that here both sentences are embedded sentence, matrix sentence, but there is a embedded clause within the structure. So that here you can see these sentences are possible, possibly means by using merge, this sentence can be generated. Similar sentence here you can see, here the structure is a little bit different, the relative sentence. Rama mo boy chiri gala ebo madhu puri gala. Rama split up my book and madhu burnt. Mo madhu ko jane, jahaku sujan madhya jane ebo sadhu pasand kare. Here actually, the five sentence number five, here it is a conjunctive sentence, but here it is a parallel merge. But in sentence number six, it is a little different structure, that you can say relative, there is a relative clause here. And here it is both parallel and internal merge actually take place. So that very common, the very common structure you can see here. Here you see merge always, it is a process of a combination of a syntactic object. But merge always combines only two set syntactic states, two syntactic set which contain some syntactic object. But merge cannot actually create a single, it always generates a single set. Two set, actually here two syntactic object you can say A and B, and it creates one set that is A, and it will generate, you will derive another structure, then it will be C, and here C and A will be merged. C and A are two new sets, and B is the primary set you can say. So that it means merge always takes two syntactic object and create another new states where two syntactic object as a set merged. Then when new derivation will it take, then when the set will be more than, it exceeds the existing set, then it will be new derivation. Suppose for example you can say C is a new derivation. It actually C, actually, the number of set are in A, actually C exists, actually exists A and B. So that it becomes, since it is a new one, then it is a type of a new derivation. So that, the set merge always combines two set and create another new set, and merge always create new derivation, and merge does not actually combine the syntactic position, only syntactic set only. You can say syntactic object. Here you can say very common example, Rama kahila je madhu asiba. For example, je Rama told that madhu would come. Here you can see asiba, here is a verb, then madhu here, then it is IP, then it is under VP, then it is IP, then it is CP, then next another sentence is here, that is, it is a complementizer, then it is XP. Actually you can say all these are set, then when set, actually number of set is growing, then it is new derivation. You can say this is the one derivation, this is the second, another one, this is the third one, this is the last one. Then the entire whole sentence is derived in this way. And this nodes are actually the process of a merge. This is only take only two set, not positions are. These are the different positions. Then you can say the application of merge. Merge can be applied in three ways. One is external merge, and second one is internal merge, and third one is parallel merge. Here we see it is an internal merge. Internal merge always takes place in coding the or assigning the theta role of the verb. here you can say actually pasand kare, you know, tutu likes me too, likes tutu, tutu the verb is pasand kare, likes. Here actually the internal criterion is actually internal argument is tutu and external argument is me too. And tutu actually this is the the external mode which helps actually to formulate, to fulfill the semantic role of the verb, what the verb projects. So that it is called always inter external merge. And here you can see the internal merge. Suppose call tutu, kahaku tutu bhala pae. Actually here external merge takes place in that situation when a particular syntactic object actually moves to another position, but it is also involved in its original position. For example, we can say the kahaku as a object, it is a, you know, within the VP, and it moves to the actually CP position here, so that it is derivation. First it occurs here, after that it moves here, so that it is called actually internal merge. Then parallel merge, you see, parallel merge occurs in that place where a single element, syntactic object, actually merges simultaneously in two places. For example, you see, Rama mo bahi chiri dala, eva madhu podi dala. Madhu mo bahi podi dala. Actually, Rama split up my book and madhu burnt. Actually, madhu hot burnt mo bahi. Actually, mo bahi, actually it occurs in both place, actually in the VP of, actually in the imminent clause and in the matrix clause. In both clause, actually, same subject merges in both clause, so that it is called parallel merge. Then, actually,
you have 3 minutes only.
Okay, this is a merge. Merge actually delivers a grammar. Here you can say, for example, merge delivers a grammar in it two ways. One is mapping the position of the syntactic position and a syntactic category. Here you can say, my mu jane loko ko jane jahaku madhu bhetti thila ebon shyama pasand kala. Actually, here the sentence is ungrammatical because shyama ku pasand kala. Actually, shyama takes ku as a accusative marker. It must be object, or we can say the present of the verb pasand kala, but it occurs in the subject position. That here you can see, this is the object position, but the subject occurs here. So that the sentence is ungrammatical. This sentence is ungrammatical. So that merge delivers grammar. It means a syntactic rule emerges here. That is, if subject occurs in the object position, then sentence will be ungrammatical. Then second, this is the appropriate mapping of subject and with its position, so that the sentence is grammatical. Kon Rama chiri dala ebo shyama podi dala. Then more another thing can deliver grammar, that is interaction between two merge application. For example, internal merge and parallel merge. Here you can see the syntactic category, both syntactic category, actually they occurs in the appropriate place where it is when it occurs here, it is an internal merge, and when it occurs here, then it is a parallel merge. Then both merge actually takes place simultaneously, so that the sentence is grammatical. Then similarly, you can see it actually in the manner of a speaking verb. Here the child, suppose Pilati Kostare chitkara kala, but here actually you cannot formulate the question sentence what the child yelled out. You can say how child yelled out. It can be possible, but since it has no object, then merge does not allow us to create the question sentence where question must be about object. This is actually how merge delivers grammar. Then operation merge, I have already told you, merge always based on a particular operation. Operation means something you can see here. You see, these are four strategy in which the merge, you can say the combining process is applied. But here you see, x plus y, someone y plus x, it is okay, where all the x, y belongs to field. This is a particular space. it creates particular space here, where it is okay. But here you see the different action is here. The same merge, you know, combining process is applied here, but the action or operation is different, so that x plus y plus z is equal to x plus y plus z. Here actually this the result of this one is different from this one. Also you can say the result of this one is also different from this one, so that the merge is same, the process is different, so that result is different. So a similar thing you can see here, x into y, suppose x into y plus z, here xy plus xz, actually two different results because the operation is different. Here it is a simple thing, simple combining, you know, addition. This is the commutative rule, this is a commutative process, this is the associative process. Similarly, you see here, since it is a x plus zero, then it is also the result is zero. So that my summation is, when operation, it may be same merge, but when operation is different, then the structure will create new space and a new meaning, and the result will be something different. You can see here. So that the question is that how we formulate the sentence that creates different meaning, and that meaning creates different space. This is actually the significance of merge. Then you can say, you can go to the space. Space as a logical structure generates meaning. Actually here you can say the every derivation has a particular space. Actually here research question is that actually Barbara Sitiko and Martin, they argue that there is only one workplace from which the derivation of all the sentences actually take place. But similar another type of argument is also exist in literature, that is Joycelyn, Nons and Urgenka and Collins. They argue that no, there is a specific space for a specific derivation. It means each derivation has a specific space. So that from this conclusion, you can see that since operation is different, but then space is different, then it creates different derivation. So that merge may be equally applied in all the structure of sentence. If the operation is different, then space is different and the meaning is different, then this is a different space for a different derivation. This is the main conclusion. So that here you can some examples, you can see some summing up, there is no only single space for all the derivation, each sentence has a working space. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Lanka. Thank you for such a good paper on merge operation and space with reference to ODIA. Thank you. Now there is time for one question or one comment. Yeah. Dr. Lalit Rajkumar.
Can we go to slide number 8 or 9? Your fonts were a little too small. I couldn't actually see.
Slide number 8.
8 or 9, I'm not too sure.
This one.
Okay. So, here you are talking about the operation merge in general, right? In this slide. Okay. So, here for this, what kind of merge are you considering this for this particular picture?
This is the merge of a particular, complementizer sentence. For example, Rama kahila je, Rama told that Sam will come. Okay. This is the told that Sam told.
So you are going to the data. So what I'm asking is, you have distinguished, it's in the literature also, you have distinguished merge into three types, right? External, internal and the parallel merge. So which one will you consider this picture?
John will come. Okay, this is external merge.
You said external merge. I don't think this is external merge, because if you remove the C part, the second merge, if you just look at the A merging with B, to give A. This is not an example of external merge. This is actually an example of internal merge. External merge should give a completely new set, like alpha merges with beta to give gamma, right?
No. I am not agree with you. Actually, you see literature. Actually, people have defined. This is absolutely. If you say it is a internal merge, can you say how it moves to a place?
Yeah, we are just looking at the diagram, the simplified version, right? With the bigger version, internal merge has to have two steps, copy plus move. Two operations you have removed. Yeah, okay, we'll talk about this. Yeah, it's going to be a longer discussion. And another thing, while we were talking about the parallel merge example.
One minute.
Yeah, sure.
Easy.
Okay.
Sorry. Here is it.
Yes. Parallel merge means. We are not talking about parallel merge. Here again, you use the term matrix clause and embedded clause. Matrix clause and embedded clause goes along with subordination, set-subset relationship, right? Rather, this is S1 and S2. It's a coordinate relationship. So it's a coordinate structure. So this is not matrix clause, embedded clause, construction,
Sir, you're right here. Actually, this is not a matrix. This is actually coordinative clause. Okay.
There is
no matrix or embedded.
Thank you. Dr. Ramu, I have seen that you have raised your hand, but we don't have time.
I was supposed to say the same thing that Lalit has pointed out. This is not a structure of embeddedness, in fact. So there is a coordinator, the earlier case also, I think it was something little doubtful over the external and internal sort of thing, in fact, the earlier one that you were talking about. Of course, in the A case, it is merged, but when again you are adding with another structure, then finding as a C, then it is not internal actually, in fact. It can be considered to be external also, but I think this is just because of the assumption just in the space of a Cartesian plane, in fact. So there is another approach by radical minimalism, so where some dimensional and dimensional tuples are considered, then we can see the problem of space. I think you can also see the radical minimalism approach also, where how merge is actually handled in that case. It's just a suggestion.